Hi, my name is Lillian Torres. I'm excited to be sharing with you today a piece of my thematic unit. The subject is science and the topic is extreme weather. This unit was developed for fourth graders. The lesson that I'll be sharing with you today is entitled Feeling Hot, 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 Learning About Volcanoes. It promises to be an explosive one. Enjoy! This lesson was designed to address the Common Core Standards for Elementary Science for grades K through 4, S3 1A, accurately transfer data from a science journal or notes to appropriate graphic organizers, as well as the Common Core State Standards for ELA for 4th grade language, form and use progressive verb tenses. Learning objectives. The cognitive learning objective states that students will be able to diagram and explain patterns of volcanic activity over the past 2 years. The linguistic objective states that students will be able to use past tense verbs to describe historical volcanic activity and future tense to make predictions. Lastly, the socio-affective objective states that students will be able to show self-reliance in individual work. The learning strategies that will be used in this lesson include data collecting, graphic organizers, prediction, and whole group discussion. The following is a list of materials and resources required to execute this lesson. In the preparation stage of this lesson, I will encourage students to pull from their background knowledge to discuss what they already know about volcanoes. I will then proceed to show a video clip about a volcano erupting, just to attract their interest. Lava come down soft and hot. You better love me now or love me not. Let me say now, I don't know. Finally, I will introduce the text to study. That's Volcanoes by Chuck Garofano. In the presentation stage, after introducing the objectives to students, I will present a short video clip about line graphs.
There are many different types of graphs. All of them are used for different reasons, but all of them make information easier to read. A line graph is used to show how the quantity or amount of something changes over time. For example, I recorded how many apples I ate each month for 6 months. Here is my data in a tally chart. Remember, data is the information you collect in an investigation. At the end of 6 months, I can add my data to a line graph to show how the number of apples I ate changed over time. After I add labels to the side and the bottom, I can begin to plot the data. When you plot, you put the data in the right spots on the graph, like this. Plot that point, and plot that point. There. And now each point on the graph shows the number of apples I ate that month. To make it a line graph, just connect each point in order, just like a dot-to-dot picture. This makes the data even easier to read. In this line graph, it is easy to see that I ate the greatest number of apples during the third month, 10 apples, and I ate the same number of apples in the next 2 months. I know this because the line doesn't go up or down. It goes straight across. And in the final month, I ate the least number of apples, only 3. Look how many more I ate in this month than I did in this month. All we need to do now is add our title, Apple Time, and done! The perfect line graph.
After ensuring the students have understood the purpose behind line graphs, as well as how to read and develop one on their own, I would model the thought process behind making predictions by studying a sample line graph that the students and I developed together. Let's say this line graph shows how much money I made each month by selling lemonade. While it appears in the month of March, I made about $50 selling lemonade. While in the month of August, I made about $450. Wow, it was a great year for lemonade sales. By observing the data in this graph, I could predict that by the month of September, I will have made around $500 in lemonade sales. I came to this prediction because I noticed that in each month there was a consistent and gradual increase in the amount of lemonade sales. Now it's time to apply our newfound knowledge of line graphs to the topic. In this part of the lesson, I would ask students to work independently to collect data that reflects volcanic activity over the past 2 years. After students have collected this information, they would be asked to transfer it into a table within their science notebooks. Students would then be able to create their very own line graph reflecting the information they found. Finally, students would be asked to study their line graphs, make predictions for future volcanic activity based on their findings, and record their predictions in their science notebooks. The following is a rubric I developed using a scale from 1 to 4. You would be able to use this rubric to assess the progress each student has made on each of the learning objectives set forth. The categories are: student collects relevant data, student organizes data onto a table, student creates and labels a line graph, student transfers data from table onto a line graph, student makes predictions based on data, student uses past tense to summarize data, student uses future tense when constructing predictions, and student shows self-reliance in independent work. 1 identifies that a student struggled at accomplishing any of these objectives. 4 identifies that a student achieved the objective and performed with excellence. The total score could be calculated and recorded at the bottom of the rubric for grading purposes. Well, this lesson sure was great. But before your students go, leave them with a homework assignment so that they can expand on what they've learned in class. Students should create a line graph to demonstrate a trend on any topic they wish. Students must make a prediction based on the trend and be prepared to discuss their graph as well as their prediction with their classmates. I hope you've enjoyed this 4th grade science lesson about volcanoes. Feel free to use this lesson in your own science classroom and make any modifications necessary to meet the individual needs of your students. Here are a list of the video resources I used in my lesson. Thanks for watching! Until next time.